Dear fellow activists, I thank the officers and members of Kabataan para sa Tribong Pilipino, Katribo, for inviting me to speak on semi-feudalism in the Philippines. I salute you as an organization of indigenous youth and student advocates from different schools and universities dedicated to uphold the indigenous people's rights. I appreciate highly that Katribo has done a great deal of work to deepen the awareness and understanding of the youth on the issues, plight, and struggles of the indigenous peoples, to organize and mobilize the youth to advocate IP rights and undertake solidarity actions for the struggles of the indigenous peoples, and to generate financial, material, technical, and volunteer support for IP communities. I make this opening statement to underscore the relevance and impact of semi-feudalism on the indigenous peoples, to acknowledge the fact that fertile land and other rich natural resources are in their ancestral domain and have been coveted and ravaged by the semi-feudal gang of foreign corporations, big compradores, landlords, and bureaucrats, and to point to the important role of the indigenous peoples in asserting the right of self-determination, the right to their ancestral domain, and all other democratic rights. The entire Filipino nation owes a great debt of gratitude to indigenous peoples for their integrity and heroic struggle against the colonial and feudal system imposed by Spain, and then against the semi-feudal system under the colonial and then semi-colonial domination by US imperialism. The indigenous peoples have also cooperated with the resistance of the people who are on the seacoast and along the big rivers and who have been more exposed to foreign aggression and domination. The indigenous peoples resisted effectively the attempts of the Spanish colonialists to grab their land and gold mines in more than three centuries. Thus, they have preserved their integrity, identity, customs, and other cultural traits. But in the semi-feudal system, the US imperialists have used their military prowess and the Philippine reactionary state to make relatively more successful incursions in the ancestral domain of the indigenous peoples and grab the land and other natural resources from them. In the current semi-colonial and semi-feudal ruling system, the US and its imperialist allies and the local exploiting classes of big compradores and landlords have made the Philippines a cheap source of raw materials for export. In this connection, they keep on expanding their mining, logging, and plantation operations and building dams to generate power and irrigate the plantations. They do so by aggressing against the indigenous people and grabbing their land and other natural resources. The social structure of the indigenous peoples have been affected by the dominant semi-feudal mode of production and superstructure. Amidst mass poverty, there are a few who own productive property and who get higher levels of education. Among the poor, some of them have become workers in the mines, logging sites, and plantations. But most of the indigenous people belong to the peasantry. They have class brotherhood with the poor settlers and Sweden farmers who are driven to till land where it is not yet owned and controlled by the land grabbers and landlords. It is in the interest of the indigenous peoples and the entire Filipino people that they are aroused, organized, and mobilized to rise up and struggle against foreign monopoly capitalism and the local exploiting classes. Only within the framework of the people's struggle for national and social liberation can the indigenous peoples effectively assert their right to self-determination and benefit from their ancestral domain. Against the reactionary state, the right to self-determination extends to the right to secede or engage in armed revolution. Only in relation to a non-oppressive state can the right to self-determination allow local autonomy and integration of the Filipino nation. The rights and interests of the entire Filipino nation and indigenous people can be harmonized in order to uphold and realize national sovereignty, democracy, social justice, economic development, cultural progress, and international solidarity with all peoples. Thank you. I'm ready to receive your questions and answer them.